Can you see me?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now you're done. Okay, can we go to chapter 1? Your hands. Now, I want to start with what we did in set 2 first. Okay, it's called the zero product equal.
Zero product.
Can you let me explain this? Come on. Now, what we need is this. I need to copy everything. Just listen to me. I will tell you what. When I have A times B equals to 0, remember the equation? If I have A times B equals to 0, it will mean what? Either A equals to 0 or B equals to 0. This is called the zero product rule. Okay, that means when you have something times something equals to 0, either one will be 0. Now, this is only true for 0. It is not true for any other numbers. Okay, now for example, if I have A times B equals to 4, does it mean that one of them got to be 4?
No.
Only enough. I can have A2, B2 is also 4. I can have A half, B8 is also 4. Maybe not be 4. It only is only true when it is what?
0.
So you must check that this is called left hand side. This is called what? Right hand side, you must check that your right hand side is 0. Understand? So this is what we learned last year. Okay, now, if you look at an example, example 1. Okay? Alright, let's take a look at this example. Solve the equation. Terms of something like something. Okay, and as you can see, this one we will use the cross method. Okay, now let's do the cross method. It's x, x, right? You can use the multiplication frame as long as your teacher teaches you with the frame. Alright? So I have 6 and 1 is a negative 6, right? Alright? Yes or no? Because negative 6x plus x will give me negative 5x. You must always check the middle term, remember? Now, so I will have, am I right? Yes or no? So how should I do it? X minus 6 equals to 0 or? So I'll have x equals to 6, x equals to 1. That's how you solve it. I just want to know, can you remember this method? This is called factorize already equals to 0. Okay? Now, a lot of students, they are very fine. Once they learn how to memorize, they forgot the basic. Let me tell you, in exam, if they said like this, solve means find the solution. Find the value of x. Can you see it's already two factors? You can straight away start solving, right? That means I will get x equals what? 3 or x equals to negative 2, right? Some people will be very funny. I told you this already. This is already the answer, right? Very funny. I got to expand. Then I simplify. Oh, then I factorize, huh? Then, oh yeah! You laugh, what? You laugh. It's always happened during the exam. Now, I think. You like this or say that? What's first? You expand only, factorize only, answer wrong there. Understand or not? If factorize only, okay, go now, just go and solve. Understand? But you must make sure this side is what?
Zero.
Zero. If it's not zero, cannot. Must expand out, bring everything over, make the side zero. Everybody clear? Everybody clear? Okay, next one. Another common mistake.
Equals to zero.
What do I have?
X equals to zero.
will tell me, oh, like that, x squared equals to negative 4x. Then they divide my hands. What's wrong with this one? You're dividing by x. You don't divide by unknown. Because an unknown may be 0. You cannot divide by 0. Do you understand? If you do it this way, can you see you missed out one solution? Yes. Everybody clear? With what I'm saying here? Yes or no? Yes, okay? So are you clear with what I'm saying? Okay, huh? So the zero product rule, make sure this side is zero and then you factorize. This is from your section. Are you okay? No problem. Okay, then another one. If I have x squared equals to 25, x will be plus or minus square root of 25, right? Okay, x will be what? Plus or minus 5, right? Now, how come for two answers? Let me explain to you. Because 5 squared is 25. Negative 5 squared is also 25. That's why there are two solutions. But if I ask you for numerical value, what's square root of 25? Answer is just 5. Answer, because there's an invisible plus down here. Answer, okay, go over plus minus 5 is wrong. You understand? Only for solutions. Okay, now, because of this concept, right? I can do something. Perfect square, huh? square root of 49. Alright, that means x plus 3 is either root 40 or negative root 49. I like to separate them so that I can see. Okay, now you do side by side, I mean one by one. X equals 1 minus 3, right? Now, I think last year your teacher said, final working must be the 3 single figure. All working must be defined single figure truncate. What's truncate?
Just cut
away. Very good. What's wrong off? You must see what's the previous one, then you see whether you add or subtract. Okay? Now how about here? Okay, all of you key the calculator. 3 cylinder figure is not present. Expression means that means no left hand side, no right hand side, just the thing, okay? expressions in the form a x plus a squared plus b. Okay. Now look at this. Do you all agree that this is an expression? There's no left side. There's no right side. Alright, everyone look up. I must plus something squared. Okay? Now, if you add something squared, you must minus that something squared, then it will be equivalent. Okay? If you add something and minus something, you must make sure it's the same, and these two are equivalent. Am I right? Because I'm not doing anything, I'm putting the same. Okay, now what do I do there? Okay, all of them are in. Can you see this is a 10x? What is, look at the coefficient. Coefficient means the number in front. What's the coefficient of x? 10. What's 10 divided by 2? 5. Now I put in 5 up. Okay, I'll tell you why. Okay, she and those things. Okay, look here. Now, why point that out? I just want you to look up here first. Do you agree that if I plus 5 squared minus 5 squared, you see the same thing is 0? Then I still get the same thing, right? I'm just rewriting in another form, but it's the same. Okay, now, I'll look up. This one can be written as this way. Remember? A squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So it's x squared plus 10x plus 25, right? Alright? That means this one I can combine to become this way. Then I minus what? 25, right? Because 5 squared. This is called completed square form. That means I put it into something square, then there's a number. Okay, now, don't the question say this? X plus a plus b. It doesn't matter if it's a negative. That means my b is what? Negative 25. Okay? You know what I'm talking about. Even if this is negative, it's fine. It doesn't matter. Okay, I'll repeat that. This, first of all, we start with an expression. Can you see it's an expression? When we add something, we must minus something, then it will be the same. So what do we add here? We add this one divided by 2. Understand? Now, how do I know this is a plus? Because this is a plus, this will be a plus. If this is a minus, this will be a minus. Because minus 2ab. Remember just now I told you, a squared minus 2ab. Okay? Now, don't have to worry. I'll do some more until you know. Okay? Next one. Right? What if I have x squared minus 5x? Same thing, wrong method, wrong right. So, x squared minus 5x. I must plus something and minus something. Something must be the same. What should be that something? 5 over 2. You must always take this number divided by 2. Don't take the sign. No need to take the sign. Right? Your text will just go to confuse you. That's not finished. Okay, don't need to take the sign. So, this will be 5 over 2. 5 over 2. Okay? Just now how come it's 5? Because it's 10 over 2 ma? Understand? Okay, so this one will become x minus 5 over 2 squared. And that means this one will become this one. Okay? Then minus 25 over 4. Am I right? Correct. Now, if you don't believe me, right? If you don't believe me, let's expand this out. What's here? Excuse me, what's here? X. What's here? X. 5 over 2. 5 over 2, right? So, x squared. Can you see these two and these two cancel? Yes, here. So, minus 5x plus, can you see? 25 over 4. Everybody clear? So, I'm trying to put this into a perfect square, then extra one outside. Everybody clear before I say? This is rewriting. Can you see actually I didn't do anything? Can you see this part is still the same? This is the extra but it becomes zero. But it's the same. Everybody okay? Just when you eat the pizza, then it comes like pizza, it's the same. Nothing, huh? You did nothing. Alright. Now then I need to do the next one. I forgot to follow the next one. This one later then you take it out.
just tell me divide by 2 means times half. So 3 over what? Do you agree this is 3 over 8?
Yeah.
Can you see? Because you know what I want to do this. Some people when it comes to fraction, they are, you know, they die, they don't want to come. Actually, divide by 2 is 7 times half. Everybody clear? Okay, so, can someone tell me what in the next step? Why you should know? Next one. Plus 3 over 8 square, right? Minus? What is this? What's 3 over 8 over 2 square? 9 over? Everybody here? Cannot. I'm going on to the last example. Tomorrow I'm going to do this again. Because we are going to do this. Okay, now, let's look at the third part. Just stop it.